All right, welcome back to our channel, guys. I'm Rod. I'm here with my dad.
I'm Rod Sr.
And we are
Bridging the Gap.
And yeah, thank you so much for watching our channel. If this is your first time here, or if you're returning, please go ahead and hit the like button on this video. Also, drop a comment, subscribe to our channel, and turn on your post notifications to make sure you don't miss any of our new videos. This week, we will be continuing our exploration of Dr. Dre. So we'll follow up. We did last week The Chronic, and this week we're going to be doing The Chronic 2001. What'd you think about The Chronic, Dad?
The Chronic was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I learned a lot about Dr. Dre during that session. So
yeah,
it was pretty good. Most of the stuff on it was the G-Funk stuff. Of course, I like that. So, and hopefully, I haven't heard anything on this, I don't think, of this on the 2001. So hopefully we can find some good stuff on that as well.
Cool. Yeah, a lot of people really liked your reaction to the, what was it? Oh, the D's Nuts.
Oh, yeah.
With the Nate Dogg.
Yeah.
I can't be faded.
Yeah, that was good. That was good.
Yeah, I made a little short and put it on YouTube of that part where you singing that. And yeah, everybody really enjoyed that. So, yeah, so we'll keep it going. So just a little background for my dad. The original Chronic came out, was that 1992 or something. And then the successor, which was 2001, actually released in 1999. And it was his second studio album by Dr. Dre. It was released November 16th by Aftermath Entertainment. So he's no longer with Death Row at this point. He's now has his own label by the name of Aftermath. And in conjunction with Interscope Records. So the album was produced mainly by Dr. Dre and Mel-Man. Mel-Man and Dr. Dre have worked on The Chronic as well as Eminem's records. Also some additional production by Lord Finesse, features by several guest contributors such as the D.O.C., Hittman, Snoop Dogg, a couple of guys from the original Chronic, Kurupt, Daz Dillinger, Xzibit. Eminem is on this record as well as Nate Dogg. So 2001 exhibits an expansion on Dr. Dre's debut G-Funk sound and contains gangster rap themes such as violence, crime, promiscuity, sex, drug use, and street gangs. The album debuted at number 2 on the U.S. Billboard 200 chart, sold 516,000 copies in its first week, and it produced 3 singles that attained chart success, and the album has been certified 6 times platinum at this point in time. And, yeah, so super successful album, had some really great singles. Another, you know, a lot of G-Funk on here, kind of like an expansion of that, obviously, a few years later, so the sound is a little bit different, more polished, I would say. Just mixed and mastered, and sonically it sounds, in my opinion, better. But you know, that'll be up to you to decide which one you like better. And yeah, so I'll go ahead and get this pulled up. Actually, usually have that pulled up. Genius. Right, and so the first track here is entitled Lolo. It's the intro, and then it rolls right into the first track, which is entitled The Watcher. Excuse me. All right, ready? Want to go ahead and get right into it.
All right, let's do it.
Here we go. Lolo, the intro, and then we'll roll right into The Watcher.
God damn. Hey, what's up, nigga? Oh, shit.
What's up?
Hey, that motherfucker clean.
Who was that?
Nigga, that's Dre, nigga. That's a, look at that,
that
shit.
Nigga hanging that motherfucker.
What up, Dr. Dre?
Things just ain't the same for gangsters. Times is changing. Young niggas is aging. Becoming OGs in the game and changing. To make way for these new names and faces. But the strangest things can happen from rapping. Yeah. Niggas get wrapped up in image and acting. Niggas get capped up and wrapped in plastic. Zipped up in bags when it happens. That's it. I've seen them come. I've watched them go. Watched them rise. Witnessed it and watched them blow. Watched them all blossom and watched them grow. Watched the lawsuits when they lost the dough.
Everywhere that I go, ain't the same as before.
Watch it,
I used to know, just don't know me no more.
But
everywhere that I go, got I got people I know.
Watch
you got people they know. So I suggest you know.
I moved out of the hood for good, you blame me. Niggas ain't mainly at niggas they can't be. But niggas can't hit niggas they can't see. I'm out of sight, now I'm out of they dang reach. How would you feel if niggas wanted you killed? You probably move to a new house on a new hill. Mm. And choose a new spot if niggas wanted you shot. I ain't a thug, how much Tupac in you got? Mm. I ain't no bitch neither. It's either my life or your life, and I ain't leaving. Whoa. I like breathing. Cause nigga, we can go round for round, clip for clip. Shit. 4 pound for pound. Damn. Nigga, if you really wanna take it there, we can. Just remember that you fucking with a family man. Uh-oh. Got a lot more to lose than you. Remember that when you wanna come and fill these shoes.
Watch everywhere that I go, ain't the same as before.
Watch
people I used to know, just don't know me no more.
Watch
everywhere that I go, I got people I know.
Watch
I'm dangerous to people who look like strangers. But now we got a new era of gangsters, hustlers, and youngsters living amongst us. Looking at us now, calling us busters. Can't help but reminisce back when it was us. Nigga, we started this gangster shit. And this the motherfucking thanks I get. It's funny how time flies. I'm just having fun, just watching it fly by.
Watch everywhere that I go, ain't the same as before.
Watch
people I used to know. Just don't.
I wasn't like it.
I got people I know.
Watch
you got people they know. So I suggest you lay low.
Watch.
Yeah. It's
watch.
When it ends, you almost want to say, oh, at the end.
All right, so that was The Watcher. That's track two off of The Chronic 2001. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I love that song.
Yeah.
Yeah, that beat was just, it was, oh man, it was killing.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Everywhere that I go, I got people you know.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh man, and then a little beat is little accents they put in there. Bing, 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 bing.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I like that. It was all, it was, that's my kind of stuff right there. I love the beat.
Yeah, dope. Yeah. So just a little background on that track. It's reportedly it was ghostwritten by Nas. Or remember how I explained like Dr. Dre really didn't write his verses on this
on these
albums. Mm-hmm. So it was reportedly ghostwritten by Nas. His verse is on here. Dre had a really long hiatus between these albums, The Chronic and then the 2001.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of people were saying that Dre had fell off and that he wasn't still the superstar producer and songwriter that he
lost
was before.
Touch.
Like he had lost his touch.
Mm-hmm.
So this album is really like that, you know.
He come out to prove.
Yeah.
I'm still here.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm still relevant.
Exactly.
Okay, I get it.
So
I
think you'll see that theme throughout the album.
Well, it came hard on that one.
Yeah, cool. So that's The Watcher, track two off of 2001. We'll go ahead and roll right into track three, which is entitled Fuck You.
All right.
And this song is featuring...
Can't wait to hear what he says about that.
This song is featuring Snoop Dogg and Devin the Dude.
Devin the Dude.
Okay. Yeah, he's a pretty cool guy. He's got some cool songs. All right, we'll get right into it.
Hi, baby. I know you're under a lot of pressure. You're working off terribly. I just always wanted someone like you in my life. I love you so much. I can do anything.
just wanna fuck bad bitches. All them nights I never had bitches. Now I'm all up in that ass, bitches. Mad at your boyfriend, ain't you? You a bad girl, gotta spank you. And gotta thank you for that head clinic. Explicit, hella photogenic. Hitman hit it. Damn, bitches. Man, this is what I'm talking about. Chicken head, chicken fed with a dick in your mouth. Out and about with your nigga like it never took place.
Hey, touch
next
me.
Time it even takes.
I just wanna fuck you. No touching and rubbing, girl. You got a husband who loves you. Don't need you all in mine. I just wanna fuck you. We can't be kissing and hugging, girl. You got a husband who loves you. You need to give him your quality time.
You got the number. It's on you to make the call. You know I come quick, help you redecorate your walls. Cut your backyard, don't have to act hard to get the cock. And if I'm going too far, I'll take it out the cancer stick. You be working it like a dancer,
damn.
Bitch. It's hard on me not to give you all of my time that you wanted. You can give me some head, but keep the breakfast in bed. I'd rather spend my morning digging through some records instead. But tonight I guess it'd be alright if we can touch bases. Hook up somewhere and exchange nice some fuck beat. Faces. I know your man's baseline. Looking for you. He's always trying to run you. Don't worry about me. Handcuffing girl, cause I just wanna fuck with you.
On the sneak tip on some creep shit. So what you gon' do, you freak bitch? You acting like you don't do dicks. That's the kind of bitch I hate fucking with.
Talking some real
baby
life
was a virgin,
yeah.
That's what she said. So I gave her some Hennessy, she gave me some head. I fucked her on the floor so I would mess up my bed. Then little half dead put his dick on her head. Take that bitch home and give her a bone. Never loving this hoe.
I just wanna fuck you. No touching and rubbing, girl. You got a husband who loves you. Don't need your all in mine. I just wanna fuck you. We can't be kissing and hugging, girl. You got a husband who loves you. You need to give him your quality time.
All right. That is F.U.
I never heard anybody make a melody to one word.
Fuck you.
Oh, man. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, what'd you think about that one?
Okay, them first two are slamming.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Devin the Dude, you haven't heard him before. He did the hook, and then he had that second verse, and then Snoop Dogg had the third verse.
Mm-hmm.
How did you like their performances on there?
Very good. I loved it. I like Snoop Dogg even better now since I've been listening to some of this stuff. When I hear him on some of the tracks, man, I'm like, okay, Snoop is smooth.
Yeah.
He's real smooth. I see why everybody likes him. So anyway. That's my take on Snoop. But some of these newer guys that I've never heard of, I'm really impressed with their talent.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's cool. First two, if he's trying to prove that he's still relevant, he came out of the gate with those first two songs, man. He's coming out strong.
Yeah. Cool. All right. So, yeah, that was track three, F.U., featuring Devin the Dude and Snoop Dogg. Next track is entitled Still DRE. This was a big single off of this album. Pretty popular song. It's featuring Snoop Dogg and it's produced by Dr. Dre, Scott Storch, and Mel-Man. So it was the lead single. It had a really dope video. We can watch that after we're done with this video.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll just let this one play. This one's a banger.
Is that right?
Yeah, for sure. Still Dre. Here we go. All
right.
Yeah, nigga. I'm still fucking with you. Still waters run deep. Still Snoop Dogg and D.R.E.
Still that.
Nah,
got that West Coast feel.
Still. Yeah. Still doing that shit, Andre. Yeah. Oh, for sure.
That's tight.
Check me out. Great day, nigga, AK, nigga. Though I've grown a lot, can't keep it home a lot. Cause when I frequent the spots that I'm known to rock, you hear the bass from the truck when I'm on the block. Ladies, they pay homage, but haters say Dre fell off. Pow, nigga, my last album was The Chronic. They wanna know if he still got it. They say rap's changed, they wanna know how I feel about
it. If you ain't up on things.
Dr. Dre is the name, I'm ahead of my game. Still puffin' my leaf, still fuck with the beats. Still not loving police. Still
rock my khakis with a cuff and a crease. Still got love for the streets, reppin' 213. Still the beats bang, still doing my thing. Since I left, ain't too
relate
much
to that. Still, the khakis with the crease.
Oh, yeah.
Crease in our khakis and our jeans.
Yeah.
Taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.O.C.
I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
From the world-class wrecking crew. I'm still at it after mathematics. In the home of drive-bys and acmatics. Swap meets, sticky green and bad traffic. I dip through, then I get
still. I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
Still taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.O.C.
I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
Still taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets. It's the D.R.E. It ain't nothing but mohawk shit. Another classic CD for y'all to vibe with. Whether you're cooling on the corner with your fly bitch,
yes.
Lay back in the shack, play this track day, driving fancy cars. Still gon' get my regards.
I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
I like it,
still taking my
hitting
time to perfect the beat.
In them
and
lolos.
I still got love for the streets.
Like
it's the D.R.E.
I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
Still
hitting them corners in them lolos, girl.
Still taking my time.
Smoke some with your dough. No stress, no seeds, no stems, no sticks. Some of that real sticky, icky, icky. Ooh wee. Put it in the air, air. Boy, use a fool, DR.
So that is Still Dre featuring Snoop Dogg off of The Chronic. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I like that. I like that West Coast sound. And it, you can always tell they have that little. That kind of. And then that snare drum on there was like he featuring through the whole thing. He kept that beat, that snare. He was banging. And I like, again, Snoop Dogg, to me, he comes out at me on this particular album. I don't know why I keep mentioning Snoop, but
yeah.
Snoop, he was like, what was that hook? He was like the Lolo something.
Hitting
like
them corners in them Lolos, girl.
Right, right. That just got me, man. I was like, oh, yeah, okay. Nice cut.
Yeah.
Nice cut.
Yeah, so it's funny you mentioned the snare. So Dr. Dre's snare is like iconic.
Really?
Like producers have sampled his snare and mm-hmm. really tried to emulate his snare over the course of hip hop because it just hits so hard. It's such a good snare.
I never knew that.
Yeah, yeah.
I knew that, but I kept hearing it and I was like, wow, that's nice.
That's a good snare.
I mean, it was like crisp and just, it was like a perfect,
yeah,
perfect pitch. I mean, everything, man, about this snare was like, whoever's doing a snare. So, nice touch.
Yeah.
Dr. Dre.
Yeah, Kanye West has actually been quoted as saying that he, like, stayed up days and nights trying to, like, get the perfect snare. And then he, mm-hmm. I think he sampled, I think what he said was he sampled the snare from Explosive, mm-hmm. which is one of the songs that we're going to get to, actually one of my favorite songs off of this album.
Okay.
And that's where he, like, perfected his snare from Dr. Dre's snare, so. That's cool that you
mentioned
that.
Wow, I never knew that there was a science in.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Perfecting the snare.
Yeah, yeah. The snare is such an important piece of the drum kit when it comes to.
It is. It carried the song.
Yeah.
It really did. It was just like, yeah, it was good. It was good.
Cool. All right, so that was Still Dre. We'll go ahead and move on to track 5 on 2001. This is entitled "Big Egos." It's featuring Hittman. Produced by Scott Storch, Dr. Dre, and Mel-Man. And we'll go ahead and get right into it.
Los Angeles Approach Control, this is Cessna 0281 Echo 119.3, over.
Cessna 81 Echo, Los Angeles Approach Control, roger.
Cessna 81 Echo is over the Compton Airport, 5-2 at 5000, requesting a ground-controlled approach to the
can I say? California, A. When niggas die every day over some shit they say. Disconnected from the streets forever. As long as I got a Beretta, nigga, I'm down for whatever. I roll with my shit off safety. For niggas that been hating me lately and the bitches that wanna break me. If Cali blew up, I'd be in the aftermath. Bumping gangsta rap shit down the blast for cash. Cause from Eazy-E to D.O.C. to D.P.G. Started from that S.O.B. D.R.E. Like Dub C, I'm rich rolling. Pistol holding. Pocket swole, nigga. That's how I'm rolling. I'm cool with S.A.'s who got AKs and cases.
Dedicated to all of those with big egos. Never faded, we get the dough and live legal. Haters, haters, we sip them out and yank the keys. Niggas play this and they roses, jeeps and regos. Dedicated to all of those with big egos. Never faded, we get the dough and live legal. Haters, haters, we sip them out and yank the keys. Bitches play this and they bend his jeeps and geos.
I bust with Mr. Tuffy, slash the Smoothie Doofy. Crash and flex on Tuesdays, harassing hoes in movies. Passing by with Uzis, and who you aiming at? That shady bitch and that bitch nigga that was claiming that. Niggas in the pen to get hit when the guards look the other way. We hitting hard, Hitman and Dre. You playing games, I suggest you know the rules. We putting guns to fools, make you run your jewels. Take your honey and cruise to the snooty and snooze. Cop booze, pop coochie to the nut oozes. You shouldn't fuck with crews this sick. Aftermath is we rude shit. I'm big hit, don't confuse me with no other about the blow, motherfucker.
Dedicated to all of those with big egos. Never faded, we get the dough and live legal. Haters, haters, we sip the mo and yank the heezos. Niggas play this and they roses, jeeps and regos. Dedicated to all of those with big egos. Never faded, we get the dough and live legal. Haters, haters, we sip the mo and yank the heezos. Bitches play this and they Benzes, jeeps and geos.
Don't call here anymore.
It went Rolls Royce on him.
We feel like Denver winds. Bitch, don't call here anymore.
Feet like Denver.
No.
What up? It's Hitman. I ain't at the crib right now, so you can leave a name and number after the beep, unless it's Tammy's ugly ass. I ain't fucking with you.
Oh snap.
All right, that was Big Egos featuring Hitman, track number 5 off of 2001. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Tammy somewhere, when she heard that, she dropped her head down low.
I probably hurt her feelings.
That hurt her feelings, man. I like that. I like the musical arrangement on it.
Mm-hmm.
That was good. I really like that. Well, so far, man, I mean, all the songs I've heard on this album, it to me, it overshadows the first one.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
So far from what I've heard, because on the last one, there were two songs, maybe three, that were just like, to me,
okay. Yeah.
So if I was going to download it, I probably would, you know, left those off and downloaded the rest.
Uh-huh.
But this one right here, so far, I can keep going.
Uh-huh.
You know, on these.
Okay.
So hopefully this stands up all the way through.
Cool. Yeah. So, you're gonna hear a lot more of Hitman on this album. He's a frequent collaborator with Dr. Dre on here. This is one of those just kind of like album cuts, kind of like a riding joint, you know.
Yeah, I like the part where there was a part in there where they kept reference like they the way they made their money in the streets, now they getting the dough and they live illegal.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They kept saying that, and I was like, yeah, that's the way a lot of them did.
Yeah,
you know, they, you know, gangbangers, you know, drugs and whatever. Mm-hmm. How they got their paper, and now they, you know, they started making raps and getting a lot of money, and now they don't have to do those things. They can live legal.
Yeah,
and they kept saying that reference to that in a whole bunch of the courses. So I kind of, you know, caught on to that, but. Yeah, I like the beat and everything, and then they ended it with the Tammy thing, and I was just like, oh, okay. Somebody they don't like.
Yeah. All right, so we'll go ahead and roll right into track 6 off of the Chronic 2001. Is entitled Explosive, and this is featuring 6-2, Hitman, Kurupt, and one of your favorites, Dad, Nate Dogg.
Okay. Is this the one you said was your favorite?
This is one of my favorite records off of here.
Okay.
And this is produced by Scott Storch, Mel-Man, and Dr. Dre. And just a worth mentioning, Scott Storch ends up being like one of the greatest, one of the biggest hip hop producers of this particular era of hip hop. Mm-hmm. He produces so many hits. He just goes on this crazy run from this album on up till even he's even got like some current day hits. Mm-hmm. Scott Storch is like one of those guys where like if you get a Scott Storch record, like it's probably gonna end up being a hit. So, this was kind of his intro to like the limelight, and he had a bunch of great beats on here with Dr. Dre, and he just goes on to make a bunch of really really great records. So, hopefully, some of the records that we do in the future will have some more Scott Storch, and you can recognize that. But just wanted to mention Scott Storch is great. All right, so track number 6, Explosive. Here we go.
That beat before.
It's Erykah Badu.
Explosive.
Okay.
West Coast shit, my nigga was way to track. Girls that used to turn they back, causing me to yank they arm and pose like I would do them all. Now I'm saying thank you cause they tell me my shit's the bomb. Explosive. For my niggas drinking cognac, smoking weed, always fat, more than one firearm, chrome rims, right now. Chronic in your system, let me know. My shit's the bomb, explosive.
Yeah.
West Coast shit, nigga. Overdosage and pimping your pistols ferocious. Fuck a bitch. Don't tease, bitch. Strip tease, bitch. Eat a bowl of these, bitch. Gobble a dick. Host forgot to eat a dick and shut the fuck up. Gargle and swallow a nut up. Shut up and get my cash. Backhanded. Pimp slap backwards and left stranded. Bitch, nigga. You more of a bitch than a bitch. You ain't in the hitting pussy or hitting the switch. You in the hitting bitches off of the grip. Yep.
Oh,
all the true gangsters know.
No.
They ain't never loved no
bold.
All the hood rats still
checking
for
that's
me.
Your baby.
All my true like fans still checking for me. All the real smokers know. They ain't passing nothing but dope and D. Real trees.
Yeah.
Chronic leaves. No seeds.
No seeds.
When I met you last night, baby.
Freaky hoes clapping their hands, stomping their feet. Every now and then they put their mouth on me. Nowadays a G like me can't even call it. A 23-year-old pussy fiend and freakaholic. Pimping bitches on the regular, I put that on the G. A hustler and a player, nowadays it pays to be. Let me drop some shit about this bitch I used to know. She gave your boy the head and said don't let nobody know. A bona fide pro, I had to grab a hoe. She got freaky in your 64, I skeeted in her throat. But bitch, I'm out your pussy when I nut, for real.
Explosive, 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 explosive.
All right, that is Explosive, and that's track number 6 off of 2001 by Dr. Dre. What do you think about that one, Dad?
The title, you know, it explains itself. I mean, it's explosive. That's really good. That's a really good song. I like all the little nuances in there with the bells and things like that. Oh man, I like that. I like that. Nate.
Yeah.
That's my boy. That's my boy. You know, I liked it. This, what's this? 4 song in?
It's five songs.
Five songs in?
Yeah.
You haven't heard a bad one yet.
Dope.
All of them. All of them so far.
Cool. Would you just think about I guess what their lyrical content and what they were talking about on here?
Yeah, they was really just putting it out there about their game, you know.
Yeah,
it's how they work the streets.
Yeah,
it's basically how what they're telling you.
Mm-hmm.
That's how they rolled, you know. And they wasn't playing. I mean, I actually believe every word they said.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's how they did it.
Yeah,
you know, so. It's entertaining, but at the same time, I believe it was a reality. in their lives, you know what I mean? So, yeah, it was a good song, though, the way they played on the words and, you know, they just had fun with it at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah, I love that record. I want to say it's a sample of Erykah Badu's song.
You say that, but I've heard that. I heard that before even she came into. I just can't think. I can't put my. And you know what? Later on, I bet you I remember when I do. I'm gonna send you a text because I know that kind of hook lyric or whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
I just can't think of it.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, when you figure it out, let me know.
I'm probably gonna be trying to research the hell out of that now. Yeah. Trying to find out where I heard it from. But anyway.
All right, so we'll go ahead and roll right into track number 7. And track number 7 is entitled What's the Difference? And it's featuring Eminem and Xzibit. You know Xzibit, right?
Yeah. I don't know much about Xzibit, but I know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
When you say Xzibit. I don't know much of his work, though.
You remember, what was that show he used to do?
With the cars?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was something like
Pimp My Ride.
Pimp My Ride, that's what it was. Yeah.
So before Pimp My Ride, he used to be a pretty famous West Coast rapper.
Okay.
And he a frequent collaborator with Dr. Dre. So, yeah, he's on this one, as well as Eminem. And
Xzibit and Eminem.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And this one's produced by Dr. Dre and Mel-Man.
Okay.
Here we go.
Uh-oh. That sounds like an Eminem right there.
What's the difference between me and you? Me and you. Me and you. What's the difference between me and you? Back when Q was rolling with Lorenzo in a Benzo, I was banging with a gang of instrumentals. Got the pens and pencils, got down to business. But sometimes the business end of this shit can turn your friends against you. But you was a real nigga, I could sense it in you. I still remember the window of the car that you went through. That's fucked up, but I'll never forget the shit we've been through. And I'ma do whatever it takes to convince you. Cause you my nigga, Doc, and easy, I'm still with you. Fuck the beef, nigga, I miss you, and that's just being real with you. Hey, nigga, it ain't that I'm too big to listen to the rumors. It's just that I'm too damn big to pay attention to them, that's the difference. What's the difference between me and you? You talk a good one, but you don't do what you're supposed to do. I act on what I feel, but never dead with emotions. I'm used to living big dog style with straight coaches. What's the difference between me and you? You talk a good one, but you don't do what you're supposed to do. I act on what I feel, but never dead with emotions. You try to perpetrate, play with it. Never knew about the next level until Dre did it. I stay committed while you motherfuckers babysit it. I smash the critics like an overhand right from Riddick. Come and get it, shitted on villains by the millions. I be catching bitches while bitches be catching feelings. So what the fuck am I supposed to do? I pop bottles and hot hollow points at each and all of you.
Come on,
a heartless bastard, high and plastered. My style is like the reaction from too much acid. Never come down, pass it around. You can't handle it. Hang Hollywood niggas by they soul train.
I act on what I feel when I'm dead with emotions. I'm used to living big dogs.
Alright, hold on, hold on. Stop the beat a minute. I got something to say. Dre, I wanna tell you this shit right now. But this fucking weed is in me. Yeah. I don't know if I ever told you this, but I love you, dog. I got your motherfucking back.
Right.
Just know this shit.
Slim, I don't know if you noticed it, but I've had your back from day one. Nigga, let's blow this bitch.
I mean it, dog. You ever need somebody off? Whose throat is it?
Well, if you ever kill that Kim bitch, I'll show you where the ocean is.
And I appreciate the offer. But if I do decide to really murder my daughter's mama, I'ma sit her up in the front seat and put sunglasses on her. And cruise around with her for 7 hours to California and have her waving at people. Then drop her off on the corner at the police station and drive off honking a horn for her. Raw dog, get your arm gnawed off. Drop the sword off and beat you with the piece of a sword off. Fuck blood, I wanna see some lungs coughed up. Get shot up in the hot tub till the bubbles pop up and they know the cough's not up. Mucus and hot water. That's for trying to talk like the chronic was lost product. That's for even thinking of having them thoughts start up. You better show some respect whenever the doc's brought up. So what's the difference between us? We can start at the penis, or we can scream, I just don't give a fuck and see who means it.
What's the difference between me and you? You talk a good one, but you don't do what you're supposed to do. I act on what I feel and never deal with emotions. I'm used to living big dog style with straight coaches.
Every time he kills it.
You talk a good one, but you don't do what you're supposed to do. I act on what I feel and never deal with emotions.
That's What's the Difference, track number 7 off of Chronic 2001. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I like that as well. Again, I keep seem like I'm repeating myself. I like that. I like that. But I like that.
Yeah.
What's the difference between me and you? I like the message.
Mm-hmm.
It was like, you know, a lot of people talk a good game, but they, you know, don't
back it up.
Back it up. Mm-hmm. So they telling you that they, you know, back up what they say. And then Eminem comes in there and starts talking crazy as hell. I mean, he's in there talking about, yeah, well, if I need help with Kim, he said he gonna put it in the car and drive her for 7 hours to California and make her wave. Wave at you. And my boy, I can't remember which one it was. Was it Dr. Dre that said, I'm gonna show you where the ocean is? So he
yeah,
can,
that was Dre.
Can,
yeah.
So he can dump the body in the ocean. Man, I'm like, these dudes are just clowning.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. I like that. It was very entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
And the beat.
Beat.
Yeah.
Rocking with that
yeah.
beat.
Yeah. yeah.
Definitely
so,
that.
So they entertain you with the words, but then they got the beat that goes right along with it. You mm-hmm. know, just got you like. Yeah, it was good. That was a good one, too, as well.
Yeah. And then I don't know if you caught it on Chronic, the original Chronic, you know, it was a lot of disses toward Eazy-E. They were beefing pretty tough with Eazy-E and just calling him out and dissing him and stuff. And then Dre's first verse, he kind of references that and just kind of, you know, says that.
He apologized.
Yeah, yeah. He, you know, I'm still with you. F the beef, I miss you.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
So I thought that was cool.
I did too, because you know a lot of, I mean, I guess in that in their world, being rappers and gangsters and stuff like that, they don't always come out, you know, and show their true feelings about certain things because they always got to portray that hard,
mm-hmm.
you know, ice cold kind of mentality or attitude.
Yeah.
And by him doing that, I thought that was big of him to do that.
Yeah, for sure. I agree. All right, cool. So we'll go ahead and move right on into the next track, which is a skit, and it's entitled Bar One, featuring Eddie Griffin.
Oh, my goodness.
Miss Rock and Tracy Nelson, all produced right. by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre. You know Eddie Griffin, right?
Yeah.
He's funny.
Yeah, I saw him, some of his...
stand-ups?
Yeah, some of his stand-ups.
Yeah, I saw him live one time.
Yeah, I did too.
Yeah.
I saw him downtown.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
I saw him when the Super Bowl was here years and years ago.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
What'd you think?
Oh, he was hilarious.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've always been a fan.
Yeah.
He's crazy.
Definitely.
All right, so we'll go ahead and get into Bar One.
Damn, girl, it is hotter than a motherfucker up in here. I need
right.
to go to the bar and get me a drink, please.
Yes.
Hello?
Yeah. What the fuck you?
Let me get a Cosmo.
What the fuck you?
Damn, I have an apple martini.
This motherfucker drunk as
thirsty
a motherfucker.
Bitches.
This a drunken ass nigga.
Ooh, ooh, shit. Girl, them niggas is looking over here. Oh, shit. Don't look.
Damn. What's up? What they look like, though?
Damn, they look alright.
They fuckable? What's God up? Is they fuckable? Or what?
Chill out.
What?
Here they come.
What?
Here they come. Chill out. Damn.
And then we'll just roll right into the next track.
Okay. All right. That was so. That was Eddie Griffin. That was
he was the bartender.
Yeah. Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And then the next track is track number 9. It's called Lightspeed.
Lightspeed.
And this one is produced by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre, featuring Miss Rock, Nocturnal, and Hittman.
Okay.
Hey, what's up? My name is Dre. Can I blaze some chronic with you?
Nigga, what? For sure. Roll that shit up.
Hell yeah, still always into something. Heart still in Compton, the comp can't oppose. Dope Cali platinum classicals. Introduced you to my dog that don't love hoes and firm fiascos. Assholes, fucked you up with my last video. Tucked up doing a tango. And cash always in my grasp.
Came up in the game wearing khakis, not Kangol. Strangling hoes. When asked about it in most interviews, I just laugh. Now I vacate with hoes with a gang of ass.
Gin on Hennessy, fuck that. Where that new shit, the chronic.
That's creative.
I hang among hustlers. I slang and bang runs. When busters roll through, can't fuck with my bold crew. We will hold you captive and bust. Cause gang banging is the activity.
That sound almost sound like an alien or something.
There ain't no liberty statue. Hope you got your gat. Don't let them catch you slipping without yours. It's warfare outdoors. Ambulance, violent uproars. Trash niggas taking out like chores. I meet whores on tours. Jeans hot as pepper, so I sip champagne on stormy shores. Be on some hardcore pornographic. Toting Austrian firearms that's made out of plastic. In these drastic surroundings, it be sounding like Lebanon. Making fools retreat like Megatron and Starscream. Oh yeah, I scream on stars to get loot and cross over like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Get out your car, son. That's how I came in bougie niggas at bar one. It's either that or make front page stardom. I'm the golden child chased by Sodom. Nuke seeing guys, my bulletproof is hard to shoot me, you hear?
By the time you see him,
that means it's real fucking hard to shoot me, you hear?
Light speed, blazing chronic through the galaxy. Hydro, Doja, chocolate, Thai weed. Or we might be sipping on gin or Hennessy. Fuck that, where that new shit, the chronic iced teas.
All right, so that is Light Speed. That is track number 9 off of the Chronic 2001. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I enjoyed the creativity in that song, you know, and it took you on a little outer space trip, you know, something like that.
I don't know,
you know, with the special effects.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. And then they still managed to keep that funky beat.
Mm-hmm.
And the lyrics. I liked where you the last lyric. What was that? I thought that was one of my favorite hooks.
Light speed, blazing chronic through the galaxy.
Right, right. Hydra Doja, chocolate Thai weed.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we might be sipping on gin or Hennessy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that.
Yeah, it was like a trippy kind of vibe to it.
Yeah. Like I said, I mean, I didn't give a lot of these rappers credit that they probably deserve because, man, they clever. I mean, they real quick witted and they put a lot of work into this.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
And you can tell.
Definitely. All right, cool. So that was track 9, Lightspeed. Next track here is another single and standout record off of this album featuring Eminem. It's called Forgot About Dre, produced by Dr. Dre and Mel-Man. Again, I mentioned earlier that this album, you know, before this album, everybody's talking about Dre fell off and Dre wasn't killing it no more and all this and that, and this song right here is definitely one of them ones. It's like,
so what was this like? The first Chronic album came out in 92, and then this one came out in
99.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, that's a bit of a gap there,
yeah,
especially for artists. So yeah,
yeah. So in between time, Dre had discovered Eminem, and they had put out some Eminem records and stuff. So, you know, he was working on other stuff, and even, you know, since the Chronic, actually the Chronic was the introduction of Snoop Dogg. So that song, Nothing But a G-Thang, was like the first big song, like the first introduction of Snoop Dogg to the public.
Okay.
Then they went on to produce Snoop Dogg's debut album, Doggy Style. They had put out some Eminem records, and then, you know, so he was doing other stuff, but it was just like, oh, is Dre still Dre? He told him on Still Dre that he was still Dre, and then Forgot About Dre is another one of the big singles off of here that I think really made a big statement. So
okay,
go ahead and get into Forgot About Dre featuring Eminem.
Same OG, but I've been low key.
hated on by most of these niggas with no cheese, no deals and no G's, no wheels and no keys, no boats, no snowmobiles and no skis. Mad at me cause I can finally afford to provide my family with groceries. Y'all better listen up closely, all you niggas that said that I turn pop or the firm flop, y'all are the reason that Dre ain't been getting no sleep. So fuck y'all, all of y'all, if y'all don't like me, blow me. Y'all are gonna keep fucking around with me and turn me back to the old me.
I can feel
nowadays,
him,
everybody
man.
Wanna talk like they got something to say, yeah. But nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. So what do you say to somebody you hate?
What?
Or anyone trying to bring trouble your way? One of his off things in the blood of your way? Yep. Just study your tape of NWA. One day I was walking by with a walkman on, when I caught a guy, give me an awkward eye.
You look at
strangled him off in the parking lot, but it's dark and I don't give a fuck if it's dark or not. I'm harder than me trying to park a Dodge, but I'm drunk as fuck, right next to a humongous truck in a two-car garage.
Right here.
So from here on out, it's the chronic two, starting the day and tomorrow's anew. And I'm still local enough to choke you to death with a Charleston chew. Chicka, 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 Slim Shady, hotter than a set of twin babies. And a Mercedes Benz with the windows up when the tip goes up to the mid-80s. Calling men ladies. Sorry, Doc, but I've been crazy. There's no way that you can save me. It's okay, go with him, Haley. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre.
Me, cause I'm from the streets of I told them all them little gangsters, who you think helped mold them all? Now you wanna run around talking about guns like I ain't got none. What you think, I sold them all? Cause I stay well off. Now all I get is hate mail all day saying Dre fell off. What, cause I've been in the lab with a pen in the pad trying to get this damn label off? I ain't having that. This is the millennium of aftermath. It ain't gonna be nothing after that. So give me one more platinum plaque and fuck rap, you can have it back. So where's all the mad rappers at? It's like a jungle in a habitat. But all you savage cats know that I was strapped with gats when you were cuddling a cabbage patch.
Nowadays everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move their lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Fuckers act like they forgot about Dre.
Damn Eminem, he just, he got the right person when he wanted to get that message out on that song.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
he
yeah.
He got the right person to lay down the track with him on that one.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely, I was feeling him, man, because he was just like, he's got his anger because everybody seemed like they've been talking smack to him,
mm-hmm.
you know, and he's like, you know, I've been laying in the cut, but you know, I taught all you people. Mm-hmm. I brought along a bunch of you guys and now y'all forgot.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all, you know, you act like you forgot.
Right.
So he's giving them some, he's giving them some recall.
Yeah.
You know, let's go back and let's start remembering some of this stuff that I did, you know?
Yeah.
And then he presents himself like, but I'm better than I was before,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I was feeling that.
Dope.
Yeah.
That's absolutely the message here is, you know, just kind of, giving everybody a reminder. Come on. Yeah. I'm the one that gave you the easy ease, the Ice Cubes, the D.O.C's,
right.
The Snoop D.O. double G's. I gave you all of this. This is things I get,
right.
Man. Like, come on, man.
Right.
So, and yeah, he's just kind of stating, you know, I'm a better version of myself, you know. If y'all keep playing with me, you're gonna turn me back to the old.
Oh, you're right. So. That's another thing. I was like, oh,
I don't want to do that.
No.
Yeah. So I forgot about Dre. That was another big record, a big single off of this album,
mm-hmm.
Featuring Eminem with an awesome verse from him as well. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, Eminem wrote Dre's verses on that one. So we'll go ahead and roll right into track number 11, I believe. Correct. Yeah. Track number 11 is entitled The Next Episode. And this one is featuring Snoop Dogg, Nate Dogg, and Kurupt, produced by Dr. Dre and Mel-Man. I would say this is probably the third single off of here. Another really big record off of this song,
okay.
Off of this album. One of my favorites. Yep, this was the release as the third single. And yeah, this one's a banger.
Okay.
Here we go. You might have heard this one. You probably heard this one. We'll see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg.
On this song, when I first heard it, the first thing that got me was la da da da.
Yeah.
Then from there, I was like, yeah, okay, I like that.
DPGC, my nigga, turn that shit up. CPT, LBC, yeah, we hooking back up. And when they bang this in the club, baby, you got to get up. Thug niggas, drug dealers, yeah, they giving it up. Low life, yo life, boy, we living it up. Taking chances while we dancing in the party for sure. Slipped my hoe a 44 when she got in the back door. Bitches looking at me strange, but you know I don't care. Step up in this motherfucker just to swing in my hair. Bitch, quit talking, quit walk if you're down with the sick. Take a bullet with some dick and take this dope on this jet. Out of town, put it down for the father of rap. And if your ass get cracked, bitch, shut your trap.
I'm on one, I might bell up in the Century Club with my jeans on and my team strong. Get my drink on and my smoke on, then go home with something to poke on.
What's up, bitch?
Locust on for the 2000. Coming real, it's the next episode.
Hold up. Hey.
Yeah.
But my niggas who be thinking we saw.
My boy, yeah.
Till the wheels fall off. Hold up. Hey. Oh, my niggas who be acting too bold. Take a seat. Hope you're ready for the next episode. Hey. Smoke weed every day.
All right. That is the next episode featuring Snoop Dogg, Nate Dogg, and Kurupt. What did you think about that one, Dad?
Yeah, that's one of my old favorites. That's probably one of the few rap songs I knew back in the day. So yeah, I like that. And everything about this song was tight. And then it ends up, I like the way it ends because I like Nate Dogg.
Yeah.
He's like, hey. You know, he's like, he always got a little he tries to sing, you know. You know, so he's not the greatest singer, but he can carry a tune.
It makes you want to sing along with it.
It does. It does.
Yeah, that's a banger right there. The only thing I ever wish about the next episode is that it was longer. It's like a 2-minute song.
Yeah, it was rather short.
Yeah, such a good
song. I thought it was going to be longer.
Yeah.
I thought. So, anyway.
Yeah, that's a banger, though. All right. So, we'll go ahead and roll right into track number 12. It's entitled Let's Get High, and it's featuring Miss Rock, Hittman, and Kurupt, produced by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre.
Okay, so they keep in the fold because they ended with smoke weed every day.
Uh-huh.
And so now they talking about let's get high. So, well, smoking weed every day.
Here we go. Let's get high.
All these niggas and all these hoes in here, somebody here gon' fuck. All these niggas and all these hoes in here, somebody here gon' fuck. All these niggas and all these hoes in here, somebody here gon' fuck.
Yeah.
All these niggas and all these hoes in here, somebody here gon' fuck.
Talking that, walking that, spitting it, hoes. Smoking this, drinking that, hitting it, hoes. Fuck this, I'm hitting that, I'm hitting them both. Have one riding dick, one licking my toes.
Laid the bitch out, then I put it in her mouth. Pulled out, nutted on a towel and passed out.
Come on, let's get high. Let's get high. Come on, let's get high. Let's get high. All my shit, put something in your mouth, bitch, real tasty. I'm looking real saucy in my gangsta ass Stacey's. Hit the party, ease up, Kurupt with an ounce in. Got all the hoes in this motherfucker bouncing, bouncing.
Yo, what up, Scrub Drum? Mel-Man, what's cracking? What's up with all these old fuck ass hoes in here?
Nigga, what? I'm a hustling bitch. I like them get rich niggas, them hit the switch niggas. Yeah, little dicks always running they mouth. While a bitch is better off to masturbate and be out.
Dang.
All you bitches up in here know what I'm talking about. Get the loot, get the ice, fuck the wife, no doubt. Trying to live lavvy, marry a big dick and stay cabby. Holla back at them niggas that hollered at me. Pop the crisp, whip the six and shit. And have all y'all niggas limp when I twist my shit. Yeah, bitch ass niggas.
Miss Rock.
So good.
Shoo.
She snapped on there.
Yeah, she did. She put them in their place.
Yeah. That was Let's Get High, track number 12 off of the chronic. What'd you think about that one?
I like when they the chorus, when they start talking about Let's Get High.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. That was real good. The whole beat, everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's like a club scene where they in there trying to pull some women, you know.
Uh-huh.
They talking smack. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's like Like that beginning of the intro to all these niggas and all these hoes and here somebody here go. And that's like a call out, you know, to get the party started and stuff like that.
Yeah. I like that. He little references that remind me of back in the day when he was talking about he was, you know, clean. He was like dressed in, he had his Stacey's on.
Yeah,
used to be the thing back in the day.
Yeah.
Stacey's with the knob on it. You could just, you have to shine the toe of the Stacey's.
Okay.
It's like stood out, man. Yeah. It's like bling, you know. Yeah, I could see that.
Okay.
Know?
Word. Yeah, so that's Let's Get High. That was track number 12. We'll go ahead and roll right into track number 13, entitled Bitch Niggas. By Dr. Dre featuring 6'2", Hittman, and Snoop Dogg, produced by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre.
6'2".
Yeah.
See, 6'2", or is that some other code? Numbers for something else.
I don't know. He's probably 6'2".
Okay.
It's probably his height.
All right.
I don't know. Maybe the commenters know. Commenters, if you know the origin of 6'2"'s rap name, please let us know.
Yeah, that'd be interesting to find out. 6'2".
Yeah. Watch it be like 5'8".
Now that would be funny.
Okay. So, yeah, we'll go ahead and get into this next track. Track number 13 off of Chronic 2001.
Some good ass weed. Check it out, dog. This game is a motherfucking trip, man. Word on the streets. Everybody always try to run up on me, hollering my word in the streets. This nigga said this. Man, I don't give a fuck about what that nigga said, man. That's what's wrong with you niggas. You niggas are just like bitches. Whole-ass niggas. Talk too motherfucking much.
Speak.
Stay to your own. Get your own.
Speak.
You know what I'm saying? Be independent, nigga.
Bitch.
Shit. Bitch niggas. Bitch niggas. Bitch niggas. Bitch ass niggas.
Bitch niggas.
Yeah, I'm talking about you.
Bitch niggas.
You too. Dog, I meet more bitch niggas than hoes. Look here, and I really don't know, but that's just how I go. Dog, so many niggas like to keep up shit. And just like a bitch, niggas be talking shit. Smiling in my face and then they blast me in the back.
Real talk.
Niggas stay strapped from way back, cause payback make niggas wanna pop that shit. If you ain't ready for the game, niggas stop that shit. We rock that shit. My nigga Dre, drop that shit. No more talking, I'm walking and I'm popping the clip. Glock on the hip, set tripping, dipping and shit. If you act like a bitch, nigga, you get smacked like a bitch. Bitch niggas, bitch niggas.
These niggas don't know what the fuck is going on. Yo, dog, check it, kick back. Let me holler at these niggas for a minute. Straight off the streets of chaos and no pity. The aggravated, making these punk motherfuckers hate it. Compton is the city I'm from. Can't never leave the crib without a murder weapon. I can't live my life on broke no more. And most of these fools ain't shit but cutthroats. They smile in the nigga face. And for what? They got the game fucked up and want my thing fucked up. I done learned a lot, seen a whole lot. The top notch nigga, I'm fiending for that spot.
Bark ain't loud enough, huh? I know chihuahuas, that's mo' rah-rah. Ha-ha, I have to laugh, Dre. I bet he take bubble baths. You don't want no trouble with the aftermath staff. Trust me, doggy dog, dicky doctor plus me. No use a buster slash hussy, soft as a hush puppy. Must we break you down to estrogen? Most hated specimens of bitch nigga.
Scratching? Oh, yeah, for sure.
Pardon me.
Yeah, like some Curtis Mayfield?
Yeah, Curtis Mayfield. Mm-hmm. You got it. Curtis Mayfield. That sound like that little sound in there. What's those? Congos or something like
Tom?
Some kind of percussion.
Is it a Tom?
I don't know. Sound like, but I heard that. The little.
Yeah.
They be sampling nice, man. They have to be listening to a lot of music, though. But, I mean, you know, they pull out some nice samples.
Yeah, so that was track 13, Bitch Niggas. How would you think about that one, Dad?
I liked it. It got you in a kind of move. It's almost like, you know, you could kind of feel where they're coming from. They're like, you know, bitch niggas. And then it's like when they say it, it's like a nasty taste in their mouth. You know, when they these type of, you know, guys, you know, these bitch niggas, you know, it's like, you know, spit it out of their mouth, you know, just a bad taste in their mouth. Bitch niggas. You know, it's just like they put some oomph in
when they said it. They talk about somebody you really know.
You're right. Yeah. Exactly. So I felt that. I mean, they made you feel it.
Mm-hmm.
That's the art of being a rapper, man. When you laying down all these thoughts and these raps, you got people start feeling, you know, what they're thinking. They pull you in and you feel what they feel.
Mm-hmm.
You kind of think what they think.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like when they say rap music is like an influence
mm-hmm.
on people.
Mm-hmm.
I could see where it can influence some people if you're weak-minded.
Right.
Because everybody can't be like a rapper or a gangster, but when you put it in a song,
right,
and you pull people in and you get that, you have them thinking that kind of mentality,
right,
then you're like, damn, I see how they say it influences people, but at the same time, you gotta not be weak-minded and do what the rappers do. But still, I can see what, like I said, this song pulled me in. It was like, bitch niggas. And then you hear that bass.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was tight. That was tight and make you kind of think about, bitch nigga.
Yeah, no, everybody knows somebody you don't like and somebody that's, you know, got some of these character traits that they were talking about.
So right.
It's very relatable.
Very.
Cool, man. So we'll go ahead and roll into track 14. That is entitled The Car Bomb.
Uh-oh. The Car Bomb.
Yeah, I think it's a skit here.
Is this Eminem on this one?
No.
I was going to say, that would be something like this.
Eminem would fit that, right?
Right.
It's actually a skit, and it's a prelude to the next track.
Okay.
So we'll just roll into the next track after this skit.
All right.
And the next track is entitled Murder, Inc., and that is featuring Miss Rock and Hittman, produced by Scott Storch, Dr. Dre, and Mel-Man.
Oh, okay.
So here's the Car Bomb.
Car Bomb. Yo, Riri, come on, man. Let's get the fuck up out of here, man.
Speedy, I'm coming down.
Took a motherfucker hour to get dressed. I told you I was going to be over this motherfucker. I want to be in and out, man.
And
don't
baby,
fuck around
I'm looking good,
here.
Right? I'm looking
I'm
good.
Saying,
it's worth
fuck
the
that, man. I'm trying to get the fuck up out of here, man.
Damn.
Get the fuck up. Let me start my
fuck
motherfucker.
Fuck you, nigga. Touch me.
So they blew up, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, snap. You just got a tune up.
It's just all that.
When darkness be closing in, I'm motivated with the howling wind. With a list of chosen men, frozen in sin. Knowing that your end is beginning. Swift, silent, and deadly.
Sound like some
there's
Jason's.
No defending my plots. I know your every movement. For 6 months I watch. Could have got you at your baby's mother's house. Even at your down low weed spot. Bullets stuck to his brain like a bag, skull and fragments. I leave to clean up the dragon.
This is anybody. Murderer. Fucking everybody. Murderer.
Yeah, you know I already like that.
Murderer. For real. You'll fuck around and get killed. This is anybody. Murderer. Motherfucking everybody. Murderer. Yeah, nigga, all y'all. Murderer. For real. You'll fuck around and get killed.
He told the stash drop in exchange of the dough. Lurking through the turf, thinking how much it's worth. Give him chase
like
to
her.
The crib, and
no.
You'll be properly late. Stepped out the car, put my steel to the side of his face. Murder is the fucking case. Rob this nigga and shake the fucking spot, cause in a few it's gonna be crawling with cops. My nigga off, till his dick gets soft. Resume the wifey boo shit, cause yo, my man don't know that his bitch is straight ill, serving ass with fuck. I'm
right.
A motherfucking
murderer.
Bitch, this is anybody.
Murderer.
Yeah, nigga, all y'all.
Murderer.
Bitch, this is anybody.
Murderer.
Yeah, nigga, all y'all.
Murderer.
For real. You'll fuck around and get killed.
All right, that was track number 15, Murder, Inc. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Much respect to Miss Rock.
Yeah.
She, the way she pronounces some of her words, she sounds like she's from New York.
Oh, okay.
Because when she said thought, she said thought.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's the way, that's a to me, that reminded me of a New York accent. I'm thinking that. I'm just wondering where where she originally is from, and how'd she make it to the West Coast with the hookup with Dre. So
yeah, that's a good question. If any of the commenters know the origin of Miss Rock, please drop that in the comments for sure. But yeah, she definitely showed up on a bunch of these tracks and just really killed it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is a song, you know, about murdering. And I think they all did a really great job at describing all the type of ways they would murder people.
Yes, yes.
And you hit it on the head, too. I think it is a Friday the 13th sample.
Mm-hmm.
So it just kind of gave it that creepy vibe and
that
sinister feel to it. So that was dope.
Jason's coming to get you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. But I like that the hook that got me into it is the murder. Yeah, you might have heard me keep like murderer.
Yeah,
yeah. They do little cool stuff like that. I like that. So
cool. All right, so we'll go ahead and roll into track 16. This is entitled Education, and it's featuring Eddie Griffin.
Uh-oh.
Produced by Dr. Dre and Mel-Man. This is the 16th track, and I believe it's a skit.
Oh, okay.
All right. Education.
Oh, they say a black man is a pimp. Well, let me tell you, the biggest pimp on planet motherfucking Earth is her mama. It's her mama that told her, get a man that got a good job, girl. Make sure he got a good car, girl. And a family, but you fucked him anyway.
Ooh.
And then when you thought you're gonna lose the nigga, you went and got pregnant, didn't you, bitch? Didn't you? The old keeper nigga, baby. And then when the nigga ain't around, what do you tell the child? Oh, that nigga ain't shit, that's why your daddy ain't here, cause that nigga ain't shit. Tell the kid, mama was a hoe, I was weekend pussy, I had you to keep the nigga, it didn't work out, that's why he ain't here. But he a good nigga, cause he take care of his real family. I was just a dumb bitch trying to keep a nigga that I wanted.
All right, that was Education.
Whoa.
What'd you think about that one?
So deep on so many levels.
Mm-hmm.
So deep. You know, I like the what he said, actually.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of truth to it.
Word.
You know, crisp, kind of violent, kind of sick, twisted, kind of hateful, kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, I see where the brothers come from, though.
Cool.
I mean, you know, it's cool. It's a good song. I like it. I mean, a good skit.
Yeah.
Right?
Skit. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So then track 17 is entitled Some L.A. Niggas. And it's featuring Time Bomb, King T, Hittman, Xzibit, Defari, MC Ren, Nocturnal, and Cocaine with a K. And it's produced by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, and apparently this is the first song since N.W.A.'s breakup that Dr. Dre and MC Ren appear on a track together.
Oh, so okay.
That's pretty cool. So here we go. Some L.A. niggas.
L.A.
Yeah, nigga. MC Ren up in this motherfucker.
West, y'all.
Yeah. L.A. niggas. L.A. niggas rule the world, nigga. Y'all niggas gotta recognize, you know what I'm saying? Niggas don't wanna peep game, you know what I'm saying? But this shit come all the way back around here. My nigga Dre dropping heat rocks on y'all bitch ass, you know what I'm saying? You gotta recognize, LA niggas connected all over the motherfucking world, nigga. Recognize this, peep that.
Now in my younger days, I used to sport a rag, backpack full of cans plus a 4-4 bag. G'd up from the feet up,
hit hard.
Blew
yeah.
up from the sewer, pie crew up. Now there's another motherfucker with no future. But time by much smoother when I maneuver. Dope like Cuba, got him jumping disciples to the
I'm hoover. Coming straight out of Compton with a loose cannon. Smoke big green, call it Bruce Banner.
Watch your manners at last, another blast from the top notch. From way back with the pop rocks, I pop lock with ya. Picture this, Dr. Dre twisting with the licks, and Hitman bought a fix. The aftermath of beat two in your gut, nigga, what?
We roll deep, smoke on weed, drank it back deep. Requirements for survival each day.
They was high when they did this. They probably was high when they did all of them.
Probably.
This one, they was probably really high.
Yeah.
Give me that mic, fool. It's a West Coast Jack move. They call me Hit. Cause I spit like Gats do. Cock me back. Bus caps for my Max crew at Fairfax. We used to wear Air Max shoes, that's true. But I grew up with niggas jack you, harass you. Blast you for that set you claim. Mash on you for your Turkish chain. CKBK, loot up or flame. I ran with the gang. I help niggas get jacked for they Dane and Danes. My pants hang below my waistline. I look humble on a rumble.
Yeah.
I bang like Vince Carter from the baseline.
If I catch you touching mine, you catch a flat line. Dead on the floor, better than yours. Driving away, getting head from a whore. It's Ava Rex to the Z. Fuck it with me, might get you banned from TV. Cassette and CD, it's all mine. The whole nine, the right time. Multiply, we don't die. The streets don't lie. What, so neither do I. I'm bad for your health, like putting a pistol up to your face and blasting yourself.
Dr. Dre Lace. Liquid kings with sedans and gold rings. Haters scope the staff, but can't find no openings. We roll deep. Smoke on weed, drank and pack heat. Requirements for survival each day.
That is some LA niggas, track number 17 off of Chronic 2001. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Again, a nice beat, fresh. Each song has a nice, fresh, different beat, and they're all good. Feature sounds on this, and to me, was again the snare.
Mm-hmm.
It was banging, and I like the vocals that come in.
That was cocaine.
That was pretty good. That was pretty good.
Yeah.
You know, I was just thinking about as I was listening to this song. I've read a lot of the comments that we've gotten over time since we've been doing these, and I kept on reading Chronic 2001, and I really was so wanting to hear it so bad. I was almost tempted, but I was like, I can't listen to it. I gotta wait, and so. When you said we were doing 2001 today,
yeah,
I was like, okay, finally I get to hear because everybody's just like talking about 2001, Chronic 2001, and now I see.
Yeah. Why they wanted you to listen to it?
They were right.
Yeah.
They were right, man. This album is slamming.
Yeah,
I'm like, as soon as I get home, I'm going to download it, and then I'm cranking it on my
speakers, yeah.
Speakers at home.
Dope. I love that. And then I think you mentioned, like, you know, each song kind of has a different vibe to it. And I think when we did The Chronic, you mentioned that about maybe halfway or three-fourths of the way through the album, you thought they were kind of overusing some of the sounds
right
in there.
They were,
and,
yeah. I thought.
Yeah. And so, you know, maybe on this one, you know, he's keeping it fresh and he's keeping it, you know, it's still in that same vibe, but, you know, the sounds are a little bit more
every
distinguished.
Song, yeah, it's more distinct. Everything was, each song has its, you know, it's just, it has its own life to it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just like it because you never know what beat he's going to come with next. Like, every time you've played a song for me, I'm like, I wonder if it's going to be the one I don't like.
Mm-hmm.
And then it comes in and I'm like, oh, this is different from that one, and that one was different from that one.
Mm-hmm.
But it still had that boom, and the bass line and the snares and stuff. And they just, it's so creative on this album. I really, I enjoy this.
Dope.
Yeah, but mom, if you're out there, I know you like to watch us, but this might be a little bit too much for you.
Yeah, the last couple.
The last couple, yeah.
Yeah. Did she watch the Eminem one? I hope not.
I think she did.
Oh, God.
That's what I said. I said, no, mom, no.
Shout out to my grandma.
Yeah, she's 82.
Yeah, be watching these videos. That's crazy.
Yeah. You remember that text I told you? She said, what up, gangsta? I was like... She sent me a text and said, what up, gangsta?
That's hilarious.
Oh, man, that cracked me up so bad. Yeah.
All right. So we'll go ahead and, speaking of grandma, if you're watching, please turn this off right now. Because the next track is track number 18, and it's entitled Pause for Porno. Oh. Featuring Jake Steed. produced by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre.
Jake Steed, he sound like a porno star.
Yep, he is.
Jake Steed, is he?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. here is this skit, Pause for Porno.
All right.
Ready to get nasty.
Yeah, oh
shit.
Yeah. Oh,
he
got everything, don't he?
Oh,
make him really sore,
oh shit. Oh, my God.
All right, chill. Give me 5 minutes. Damn,
Jake Steed, bitch.
What? Freak on the bitch.
You.
All right, that was a track.
Okay.
Number 18, Pause for Porno. What'd you think about that, Dad?
They just went crazy on that one. I was just like, they just went off the charts. It's like some crazy shit there.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
It ties into track 19. So.
Okay, all right. I bet it does.
Yeah. So next track is called Housewife, track 19 off of 2001 by Dr. Dre, featuring Kurupt and Hittman, produced by Scott Storch, Dr. Dre, and Mel-Man. And here we go.
All right. See? There goes that bass and that snare. Oh.
Now this is one of them occasions where the homie's not doing it right. I mean, he found him a hoe that he like, but you can't make a hoe a housewife. And when it all boils down, you're gonna find in the end a bitch is a bitch, but a dog is a man's best friend. So what you found, you a hoe that you like, but you can't make a hoe a housewife. Why?
Mostly sold dick while I pack the gold clip. Work my money maker. She got paper, she bout to shred.
What the fuck is my money?
How can I cheat guilty? You pimping strong, but coming home the sheets that be filthy. She on the dealsy, I take advantage. All up in them panties, I got this bitch speaking Spanish. I'm mannish. Get your nails out my back. Slut, I'm about to nut and get up. Go scrub your cat. Learn the player rules. This is how a player do. Might not be a freak, but she got on a choose and shoot.
And when it all boils down, you gonna find in the end a bitch is a bitch, but a dog is a man's best friend. So what you found, you a hold it to lie. But you can't make a hoe a housewife.
Nah, why? Hoeing short for honey. Almost had to wail her like bunny. Telling tales of being pregnant, catching orsham cells with abortion money. I spotted her, seen her with my nigga when I shot at her. Now we got beef, he caught up in the hoes erotica. Exotic, she's psychotic, rocking his nautica. Soon he'll need antibiotics. Name a sexual disease, she got it like Sam Goody. You be like, damn, how could she hit me off with chlamydia? Fool, I pity ya, we live in the city ya. Ballers with more bouncing than a zap, she will do. Why did ya? The prettier, the grittier, the wittier can get her to the hotel. Nico, on some suave shit like Rico. That's when I caught a vision like Coleco. A high pole, so a perfect way for me to keep dough. Have a selling ass on Bronson Avenue Pico.
At the hotel, motel, or the Holiday Inn.
Say what, nigga?
I said, if that bitch keep fucking up, then we'll fuck her friend. Half. 9 3/4. The hoe started calling when I started balls. Give me some head, give me some ass, give me some cash. Pass it to Daz, pass it to Snoop, or pass it to Nate. Hoes eat dick like eggs and steak. It ain't shit new, I thought you knew. I knew you would, you wish you could. Break a G down, break me down. But I'ma see you on the rebound, DP style.
This little Snoop Dogg gonna look girl boy.
Yeah.
He gonna be more than half that if he don't fill my motherfucking drink up.
I fill your motherfucking mouth up.
I don't think so.
All right, that is Track number 19, Housewife.
So tight. That was so tight, that beat, man.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know what those are. Those is that the keyboards in the back or is making those sounds that ding
ding? Yeah.
And then the bass right after that, then that bass goes dun, 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 dun. Mm-hmm. Oh man.
And then they had that kind of like
and then they guitar, just like, and then they just spitting, man, all kind of crazy lyrics, dude. I'm just like, at the same time, it just flows. It's like, yeah, that was good.
Yeah.
That was really good.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite hooks on here too. Kurupt. Kurupt killed that hook.
Sorry.
On there. And yeah, it's a great track. I love that one.
Yeah.
All right. So that is track 19 off of 2001 entitled Housewife. All right. And so we are at track number 20 entitled Act Right.
Uh-oh.
And this is featuring Hittman, produced by Dr. Dre and Mel-Man. And yeah, we'll go ahead and roll right into track 20. Here we go. Act Right.
All right.
It's fucking Act Right. Question is, can I get some? You know what I'm saying? Act right, bitch. When I see you on the spot, you just act right. You know what I'm saying? When I yank you by the fucking arm, don't be looking at a nigga crazy.
We used to say that.
Give the digits
you need to
and
get you some act
out,
right.
You know
yeah.
Let me break it down for y'all. It was just one of those days when I wanted to catch sun rays. Fun to get blunted on a Sunday afternoon. Nigga, babe got groomed. Grabbed the gap for misbehaviors and the chocolate
yeah.
Bed, boom. Lost in hip-hop tones. Zoom, zoom like the Commodores.
Okay.
Wonder where we have drama or end up clowning whores. Around the four good-to-go girls like the Barbie Coast girls. Ride shotgun, baby. I be posting all well in the ride. Sipping 151 that gave me too much pride to back down. Soon as we get to the beach, I'ma put my fucking Mac down. I'm playing lead, not the background. It's time to put Bronson on the map now. Walk mm-hmm. with my hand on my Johnson crack smile. Cutest people, now we plotting pose. Plus we watching hoes with lots of flesh exposed. Getting swarmed by those type of niggas with no game but brown nose. So I impose only like pros can. Yo, is this your man? No, grab the bitch's hand. I'm Hitman, bling, gold, chain, gleam. You're very eligible for my summer league team. Maybe too extreme cause the sister got steam. Then Miss Thing tried to scream on my brethren. I got mad spit fleam on the name Stephen. And snobby ass bitches get slapped out of spite. Spite, the next back right. Frontin' on the act right, causing me to act up. Good Samaritan saved that hoe from getting slapped up. My homies crack up at the scene I made. Yo, my actions ain't serene when a nigga's on fade. If it wasn't for the one-time brigade, I would've sprayed at the hook of tramp. As cops parade, I'm afraid it's time to break camp. Make tracks, where else can we go to take hoes from fake Max? Hey, yo, chase them girls in that black Maxima. The passenger almost fractured her neck bone, looking back at us. Plus, they on the dick, cause the cat is plush. They blush, I bum rush the hush with the largest crush. Try to swing her up the night so I don't have to keep in touch. Keep it on the hush without the tipping. Mackin' interrupted by some niggas set tripping, clipping the strap. I show these niggas how to act.
In my left hand, drink in my right. Strap by my waistline, cause niggas don't fight. Sucker free for life, so you better think twice. Alright, and give a nigga smack right. I'm the type of nigga player haters don't like. Snatching up your honey for some late night hype. The snobby ass bitches get slapped out of spite. Alright, so give a nigga smack right.
Bitch, I just want to put my dick on your shoulder so you can put it on your mind later on. Stop it up.
Yo, sicko.
Take that dick off your shoulder and put it in your mouth. Drink the evidence and hide the dick behind your head. The police is coming. It's cold 10. Put this dick behind your head.
All right, that was track number 20, entitled Act Right.
Yeah.
Off the chronic 2001. Okay. What'd you think about that one?
Yeah, I like Act Right.
Yeah,
I agree. You didn't get some Act Right.
Yeah.
Then they go sicko at the end, man. Dudes are sick, man. I know they high as hell again. You know, it seems like that's all they do is smoke blunts and lay down tracks.
Yeah.
You know? So, yeah, it was cool, though. I like the beat. And they had this one little hook in there, a little beat in there that sound familiar. It's something I'm pretty sure I've heard it before.
Mm-hmm.
I know I've heard it before. Some more sampling that they do.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just like, I like doing, you know, the good thing about it is when I do hear these songs, I'm picking up on the sampling that they do. And I kind of like that when I hear that kind of stuff, because, you know, that kind of like, that, you know, like
sounds familiar.
Yeah. So it kind of, you know, makes me like it more than I probably would have, because they doing some old stuff, some new stuff, you know. So anyway.
Cool. All right. So that was Act Right. We'll go ahead and roll right into track 21. It's entitled Bang Bang, featuring Hittman and Nocturnal. Also, I just wanted to mention, too, I think it's really dope that Dre, you know, there's some of these songs that Dre's not even on. He just puts his friends on and just gives them some time to shine. Like that last song we listened to was all Hittman.
Right.
Hittman was on the whole track, his hook, his verses, and he killed it. And that's a dope record.
He did on each album, you know, of all the artists that we've, you know, critiqued. I'm learning. It gives me an insight to them too, because some of these people I've never even heard of, like Rock. Miss Rock.
Yeah.
What was the other lady?
Lady of Rage.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now different. Though, I mean, to me, Lady of Rage, she was okay.
Mm-hmm.
Lady of Rock, she shines.
Yeah.
She's you know, at another level.
That's dope.
So yeah.
Yeah, and that's why I wanted to do these albums back to back. Even though there's like some time difference between them, I wanted to do them back to back just to kind of see, because there is this debate like which one is better, you know, Chronic or Chronic 2001. So far, what
I've heard, Chronic 2001, hands down. I mean, there might be maybe one or two hard hitting cuts on the first Chronic, but man, this one right here, it just goes and goes and goes
all the way through.
All the way through.
Cool. All right. We'll go ahead and get into track number 21 on 2001, featuring Hittman and Nocturnal, produced by Mel-Man and Dr. Dre. It's entitled, that's not the right word.
What's the word?
Just titled. When you say a track, track is titled.
That's right.
But I be saying entitled.
I didn't ever catch that. They're right.
Yeah, I know. And some dude, he's like, I hate to be the person to say it, but you say it all the time. It's just titled, not entitled.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, yeah, you're right.
I never caught it.
I didn't even like peep that I be
saying
it. You
didn't realize you did it, did you?
And I think I've probably said it this whole video. That's all right.
Well, now that you've made a mental note of it right now,
right, you'll
be way more conscious of it.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, man. We love the commenters. Yeah, drop where you're watching the video from. We love hearing from, you know, where you guys are from.
That's what blows my mind.
It's a trip, right?
Because when we first did this, and I was like just doing it for fun. I was like, well, I still am doing it for fun, but you know, I was like reading some of the comments, and yo, this guy over here is from Africa. This girl over here is from Israel. I mean, it was just people from everywhere.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Austria, you know, everywhere.
Yeah.
It's mad crazy, man. I was like, oh, cool.
Yeah, they all want to hear what you think about the music. That's so cool. I love that.
They're
just so kind. Yeah. So all the nice things that they're saying. And
yeah, some of the stuff, man, was like, you know, they tugged at your heart, man. They were telling you some things, you know, personal things.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, man.
Yeah.
It really did, you know, like I said, just tugged at the heart. Some
right.
Heartwarming things they said, man. I really appreciated that.
For sure. Yeah, we appreciate all the comments. So thank you guys so much for watching our videos. We'll go ahead and get into track 21, Bang Bang.
Bang Bang. You know, they caught me right there.
Yeah.
Same thing, LA ain't changed. Niggas still play a hatin', but Dre ain't changed. I'm just a lot smarter now, cause these niggas is banging 10 times harder now. Niggas bringing their ass up in the wrong part of town. Better turn their car around, rolling their window down.
Hey, can we talk it out?
Nah, get the fuck out. Johnny got a shotgun, and he ain't even strong enough to cock one. Fuck trying to chop, huh? Niggas got AKs. Niggas is way crazier than Dre was back in his NWA days. Niggas spray strays and shoot without looking. Niggas walk by and blast without leaving a footprint. I think the attitudes are twice as worse. It takes half the time to get your whole life reversed. Always trying to play Rambo with the ammo.
to stay in family mode.
Late nights is full of lead that whistles as it goes by. Murder arrives anytime. Bullets take flight when the 4-5 ignite. Some hearts skip a beat, some get blew out in every light. With you in the sight of youngsters with automatics, busting on shit to lay everything down, even tourists and non-affiliates. These days, gunplay is official with green lights on every block. Know the sign tells you too, it's not best to stop on every corner. Cali niggas will dump and you be shaking your soul loose from the box at the coroner's, making death not so foreign to ya. Niggas got Rugers in M14s with enough ammo to leave in armored trucks. Swiss cheese, I've learned to stay away from house parties.
What the fuck is this, man? Niggas doing brothers in worse than the Klan. Yes, sir, in the killing field, I got my life preserver, and I do my time for murder. These niggas got the nerve to question me about the colors that I got on. I see that red dot on your knot. About to get your whole crew shot on. A soldier fortune, I'm the wrong man to plot on. Took him out on the spot before he even got on my hit list. Peep this. I cock back, you bow down. Bust round bloody the ground. Retaliation sounds like this.
All right, that was Bang Bang, track number 21 off of 2001. What did you think about that one, Dad?
Bang Bang, it was banging.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah. And I like when it first came in, you know, I like the little vocals on these tracks.
Mm-hmm.
And then they just, everywhere I go, everywhere. Whatever she said, bang, 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 bang.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. So, yeah. Another good one, fresh, didn't expect it.
Mm-hmm.
Different beat, different tempo.
Mm-hmm.
He keeps switching it up. He keeps keeping it fresh. And this album, like, you know, when you're listening to it, if you've never heard it before, it's like, since I've, this is my first time hearing it, every time we complete one song, then I'm ready. I'm anxious to see what the next one's going to sound like, because I'm like, oh, that was good. I can't wait to hear mm-hmm. the next one mm-hmm. coming up. So this album is nice. It captivates you. Really, it does to me.
Dope.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. So then we'll just roll right into track number 22, titled The Message, featuring Mary J. Blige and Rel.
Oh, Mary J. Blige.
Yeah. Okay. Familiar with her?
Oh yeah.
And it's produced by Lord Finesse. So this is
a different name I never heard of before.
Yeah, this Lord one. Finesse. Yeah, this one is the only one on here that wasn't produced by Dr. Dre.
Oh, okay.
A little background behind about this song. Dr. Dre made this song as a message to both God and his late brother. His brother had passed away. It's certainly different from the rest of the album, which was more centered around the gangster lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
This song was ghostwritten by Royce da 5'9", and there's like this kind of like hip hop story about how basically Royce da 5'9" had written this verse about you know, his personal experience before Dre had even told him about his brother and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it just happened to fit so well. And it was just like this crazy moment that they had in the studio and everything. So it was, you know, that's like one of those like hip hop stories.
It was like a prophecy or something.
Yeah,
like
yeah, kind of something yeah. like that. Like, you know, Royce was just talking about his personal experience, and then it just kind of ended up going really, really well with what Dre had went through and what he was trying to get across in this song. So, yeah, this is titled The Message, track number 22 on Chronic 2001. Here we go.
This one is for my brother, Tyree, RIP.
It's a hard business.
Mm-hmm.
A message to God.
Like that Hiroshima.
Mm-hmm.
No Hiroshima.
Since you're finishing them early, what possessed you to start them? We made a vow, later we'll regret till death do its part. Lord, I thought we was made for each other. You shouldn't connect those made to be taken away from each other. We could've used time spent arguing, telling the truth. He had talent too, I had plans of watching him blow. Don't know what hurts more, seeing them leave or watching him go.
Listen, listen, listen.
accidentally pulling your file. Cause I'm still paging 911, straight in denial. Praying you get it. But no man can choose the card he was dealt. You either quit or you gon' play him like you get it. I done been through all emotions, from in shock to keeping a poker face, to straight breaking down and showing all emotions. From anxious to believing real G's don't cry. If that's the truth, then I'm realizing I ain't no gangster. It's just not me. But you know I'ma always ride with you. I miss you. Sometimes I wish I just died with you.
Dr. Dre, are you a real doctor, dude? I mean, like, you know, can you prescribe some drugs for me, man? Come on, dude. I'll split whatever I get with you, okay? the chronic.
All right, that concludes Chronic 2001, that last track entitled The Message. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
That was a nice touch and a nice way to end in that the album.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't expect it. It ended on a serious note.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought in Mary J. Blige, which was a sweet touch. I like the arrangements, the strings, the violins. Still had that little snare in there, mm-hmm. and he was just like, it was a really, really, really nice song to me about his brother. So,
yeah
it's a nice storyline, and I liked it. It was very, very enjoyable. Like I said, when I get home, that's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to download this album.
Yeah.
I'm going to burn me a CD. You know, uh-huh. I'm old school. You know, so burn me a CD. And then I'm going to bump this album.
Word.
Yeah.
Dope. So just to recap, just throughout, I know you enjoyed this album. What'd you think about just kind of like, first, I guess, the message or the theme of the album and what was talked about throughout the album? What'd you think about that?
You know, everything, this album right here, basically is like, from what I gather, is like Dr. Dre on the comeback, mm-hmm. Which to me, he's telling everybody the way I hear it when he's saying it in this album is that he never left.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he might have took a little hiatus, but he still got it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then he came back, you know, strong, and he was letting everybody know what. I'm Dr. Dre.
Yeah,
I thought y'all knew,
right?
You know what I mean. So that's the message I get from him, and he said it loud and clear.
Mm-hmm.
And the body of work that he put in this album right here let everybody know that he's the man.
Yeah,
yeah,
dope. So, and what'd you think about just the overall production? You know, as a standalone and maybe even compared to what we listened to last week with The Chronic?
This was a much better production to me,
mm-hmm.
in my opinion. Just, it was so fresh. It was so, I don't even know how to describe. I mean, it's just, to me, this one overshadowed the first one by far, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
You could tell where the first one, you could tell he was raw,
mm-hmm.
and there was a whole lot of talent behind that first Chronic album.
Yeah.
But at the same time, when he came out with this 2001, it seemed like he had honed in more his talent. It was more refined.
Mm-hmm.
It was more, he just hit everything just the way he wanted it. It was just like, this one played out the way in his mind I think he wanted it to come out.
Yeah.
You know, and sometimes that's hard, I think, for artists to do. They have a vision of how they want this album to reach people. But at the same time, it doesn't always turn out that way.
Mm.
And this album right here, he has to be pleased with his body of work.
Yeah. Cool. And just overall, this is something, I know you just said that you were going to go home and burn this, so I would say this is something you'd listen to more and revisit in the future?
Oh, yeah. Once I burn the CD, I'm going to have a copy for the house and a copy for the car.
Dope.
So when people see me driving down the street with the windows down, bumping that, and they say, what's up with this old guy? Listening to this gangster rap.
Word.
Yeah. So anyway.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that concludes Dad Reacts to Dr. Dre, The Chronic 2001. Thank you guys for watching. If you made it this far in the video, please go ahead and drop a like, drop a comment, let us know what album we should review next. Also, hit the subscribe button and turn on your notification bells so you don't miss any videos when we drop them. Thanks again for everybody that watches our video. We appreciate you guys. We appreciate all the kind words and the encouraging things that you guys say and all of the support. And until next time, we'll see you guys. Bye.
That's a wrap.